are on our summer holiday. This is all we're going to be able to muster up this year, which is a Scottish road trip. But we did a similar sort of thing last year and it was absolutely awesome. We did plenty of mountains. We actually camped in my roof tent a couple of times and Airbnb'd it. So that's a similar sort of thing what we're going to do this time. And we don't have much of a plan. We've got 8 or 9 days. We've got a couple of places booked, but we're going to sort of try follow the weather and just get to see a bit of the beautiful Scottish countryside. We are heading towards the Cairngorms, purely because there's a park run somewhere there, and on Saturday Nicola has to do a park run without doubt. She will never miss one. So that has dictated a slight direction, so that's about as much as the plan goes. But yeah, looking forward to it. We have a bit of kit for all sorts of different scenarios, but I'm sure we'll be wandering up a few mountains and just enjoying what Scotland has to offer. Well, we had a 4-hour drive, just fairly plain sailing all the way, and then we arrived at the beautiful place that we're staying at, which is actually really nice. Very happy with this. So we've got 2 nights there, so we chilled out, had an hour's rest, and then we've come out to do Nicola's 5k. To our little Scottish holiday. Such a warm welcome to this beautiful Scottish old farmhouse, and the surrounding area is stunning, and it's really nice getting out for a jog because you just get to sort of get a feel of the area. And tomorrow we're going to explore a bit further and higher. That's always what I want. And there's a Munro road just close by, so we're going to get to the top of that tomorrow. Had a shower, got myself sort of ready, bit of egg white and old hair and all that, you know.
And then Nicola's just getting ready and I'm just going to chill out, make myself a cup of tea, Yorkshire tea hopefully, don't tell them. And then, yeah, we're going to go out for a lovely meal, so quite excited about that. I feel like I've earned it after the 4-hour drive. So I'm just going to get the kettle on. I'll just have to sit in this chair a minute, look at this. Bit of sunshine. So we have just pulled up at the Ben Lomond car park, and straight away we are out ready to get ourselves on an adventure to the top of Ben Lomond, which is a high mountain. 900 and something meters, I think it is, but yeah, that's where we're heading anyway. So we're kitted out, we've got our Raid Light bags on, which we both totally love. Enough kit to sort of keep us going, and you know, food and stuff just in case. I've got a bivy bag, emergency bivy, and I've got my group shelter as well, because the weather is dry and looks sunny at the minute, but it's quite a lot of cloud around and it possibly could rain, so we are prepared, because obviously we're both in shorts too. So anyway, I'll show you around and then we'll get off. Look at this beautiful Scots pine. And if you didn't know already, Scots pines produce rocks. That's where all the rocks on Earth come from, a Scots pine. Well, this is the entrance to Jurassic Park, so I'll let her go first. She's a bit tougher than I am. What a gate, eh? Solid. Here we go. We need to keep the deers out.
Empty. All crazy animals.
And that's just because there's dinosaurs in here. So we just need to be a bit aware. Luckily, she's got her poles and she's tough and can fight off any dinosaur. A good bit of advice for when you're out hiking, and that is get some arm warmers. So generally most people wear a t-shirt, I sometimes wear a vest, but with a t-shirt and a set of arm warmers you have the ability to turn a t-shirt into a long sleeve top, so that's one full layer. So if you needed to put your waterproof jacket on, pull your sleeves up,
put your jacket on, and then you've not got your waterproof rubbing against your skin. Absolutely brilliant. And obviously, as soon as you get too hot and you need to get air to your arms, roll it back down to your sleeve again. Absolutely awesome. Also, look at these babies. These are a set of Nike Wild Horse trainers, and they're like a trail running shoe, so they've got decent grips on the bottom. But honestly, I spend ages looking for the right piece of kit for me, and these, because they're quite a wide fit, they're honestly amazing. I'm absolutely loving them, and this is really the first time out, so I'm going to give them a good test this week. Anyway, there you go. So climbing up here, I mean, look at that. What an amazing view. You get that pretty much all the way up. And we are currently at 486 metres above sea level. And the summit is about double that, 987 or something along those lines. Can't remember exactly, it might be 978. But it is a lovely climb. Just nice, steady underfoot. There is quite a lot of rocks and stuff to sort of get yourself over, but really, really nice. And you just get that view all the way. Can't beat that. So anyway, onto the summit. But this is gonna be a little bit steeper. It looks quite a zigzag up there. Look at that, I found an actual heart of quartz. Beautiful, eh? And look at that, even more beautiful. There she is, look. Pretty wild. Look, there she is, leading the way. Yeah, as soon as we get up here, it's turned really windy. So, arm warmers are up. We're currently at 872 meters. So we've got about 100 meters to go. But it's wild. Love it though. Look over there. You can see all this fog just coming in, all this mist. So, we'll soon be putting another layer on just to make sure that we're safe. Got the waterproofs and everything, so anyway, let's go catch her up there. Ooh, bloody hell, it's pretty wild, like. Oh, yeah, just yeah, yeah. Yeah. 10 minutes, look at the difference, can't even see a thing. So this is the summit of Ben Lomond. My watch says 975 metres.
Oh, I think it's 974. Oh, it's 76.
978 now. Here we are. The summit. So there we go, we made it. It's quite a straightforward walk, to be honest. A little bit of scrambling, but nothing major at all.
Not really.
We can make it, and pretty much anyone out there can. So yeah, definitely worth a trot up here. Although currently there's no views, and that's what we came for.
Why are there no views, Alan?
Because, Nicola, it's claggy.
It's claggy. The clag has dropped. Yeah.
She taught me that word. You would not want to fall off that.
No, I got to the
jeez,
end.
Jeez, look at that.
It's too windy.
It's the right cliff. We just run loads and then we have to stop because she wants to make me eat a carrot and I'm not interested.
I forgot they were in my bag.
I really don't want a carrot.
Eat a carrot, Alan.
Love carrots. I do love carrots, but you know, how can you run with this in your mouth?
I mean, we can stop for a bit.
So nice.
Warm carrot. Warm mountain carrot.
Cheers. Eat carrots on mountains, it's really the way forward. Cheers.
It's got a carrot hair on it.
Well, we are back. That was an awesome run, to be honest. Say run, we probably ran about 30% of it, that's all. But yeah, lovely. Really, really nice loop back to the car park. Car park's only £3 a day, all day. So definitely worth doing this one. I just had one issue. I had about 250 yards to go and I went over my ankle. Proper bad, I've absolutely knackered it. So anyway, it's just part and parcel of this sort of game, innit? And then going over that on the ankle, it's made me put my other leg out and I've knackered my left knee as well, so. Ah dear, anyway, I'll be right in a day or two. Anyway, we are gonna get back in the car and go out for dinner. And hopefully find somewhere really nice for some nice food. I think we both deserve it after that.
There we go, my lager has a good head and Nicola's Coke has her head.
So you're going to say something else then? Are you still coming?
What have you got, Nicola? Why did you buy that? Why do you want that?
Because it sounds Scottish. Be real though.
So we've just had a lovely dinner, haven't we, Nicola?
We have.
And I had a pint or two, so Nicola's going to drive. And this is the first time she's ever driven this vehicle.
What could possibly go wrong?
This is going to be fun.
I'm a really good driver. In fact, I'm a much better driver than Al, so this will be fun and safe. I don't actually know how the handbrake works. Where's your handbrake? Oh my God, Al. Stop.
That wasn't too bad, to be fair. We made it back, look. Just in time for sunset too. Look how cool this is though, set up in Scotland. So it's a permit area for camping. So right by the lock, you've got designated spots where you can actually pitch a tent. Look, along this beach side as well. Absolutely brilliant. All you have to do is go to the local place and get the permit for it. Why do we not have this in England? Well, we're out again for our next day on our Scottish adventure. This is just the edge of Loch Lomond. We just sort of stopped off in the car just to sort of have a quick look around. And if you look in the background there, that is Ben Lomond summit up there. And that's where we were yesterday. So we climbed to the top of that. So it's quite nice to come down to beachside, just have a quick look. And look, found my heartstone already. It's about as good as you can get on this beach, but I always have to get one anyway. So we're going to continue. The day will be quite an adventure because we've got nothing planned at all. So we're just going to check out a couple of waterfalls, a few bits like that. And then I've got nowhere booked for this evening. So it means that we are either sleeping in the car. I've got everything set up for that if we needed. Or I've got a tent. So we might just sort of venture out and just find somewhere really nice to pitch a tent and then chill out, maybe with a glass of wine, something like that. Anyway, well, let's crack on and get to the next place. There she is, look, laying down at every opportunity. I think she's a bit tired.
And cloud watching.
So this is the Inverugulus, I think, pyramid, which is just on the side of Loch Lomond. And it's pretty cool. It's such a nice lookout point, and you can see it just cuts its way through, dissecting this landscape, which is awesome. And then if you look around, you get to see all this right down Loch Lomond. Awesome, that. Well, looking at that,
That is beautiful. So it will be rude not to jump in. So I think I'm going to have to get in and have a little bit of a swim.
Look at this one.
That's cold though, very cold. Awesome that, absolutely awesome. Definitely a bit cold, but just worth it, absolutely worth it. Just feel amazing after doing something like that. So what a place though, stunning, absolutely stunning. Definitely worth a look at some point. This place is awesome. It just looks to me like the most perfect place to bring my kayak and just get out and play. But I reckon in high waters, it's going to be a great five river this. It will be definitely pushing my limits. Definitely. Grade four, yeah, not too bad with that, but a lot of this, it looks well technical, but could be fun, definitely. But yeah, let me show you around.